and the wicked, and mine is not to reason why this is. In this I rest, in this I find my refuge, that my thoughts and ways are not his.
Well, hello, my Manna Minutes friends. I thank you so much for joining me here again today. All right, I'm just going to give you the fair warning and disclaimer, okay? What I'm getting ready to share with you, your flesh is going to rebel against it. Okay, now listen, don't click away, all right? It's good to keep the flesh in check. I know it doesn't sound like fun, but believe me, we need to do this one today, okay? I've thought about running an experiment. What do you think if instead of posting a now hiring ad, if instead you said, slaves wanted, or servants wanted, right? Who do you think would respond to that? Probably nobody, right? You probably actually may even get a lawsuit out of that. Because in our Western culture, the thought or the concept of being a servant or being a slave is just 100% completely foreign to us. Especially in light of what has happened in the United States history. This idea of being a slave or being a servant is such a horrible, horrible concept. But I want to read something to you. This is actually out of Romans chapter 6, starting in verse 22. But now that you have been set free from sin and have become slaves of God, the fruit you get leads to sanctification and its end, eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Now listen, this concept of being a servant or being a slave to God, or being a slave to righteousness, is not something that we have to go and dig around and, you know, and pull it up out of the cobwebs. Listen, this is a prevalent concept in Scripture. And I know, you know, that whole thing, just the word of being a slave or a servant sounds horrible to us. But listen to what Jesus says over in Matthew chapter 20. Jesus called them to him and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones exercise authority over them. It shall not be so among you. But whoever would be great among you must be your servant, and whoever would be first among you must be your slave, even as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Now, here's the whole concept behind all this. So you think you're greater than Christ? You say, well, you know, I'm a pretty important person. Well, you're not more important than Christ. And he said, I came to be a servant. Now, I know we've done a couple of episodes of Manna Minutes where I keep bringing up this concept of being a servant or being a slave. And we keep going back to that, right? Well, listen, I didn't get a special missive from God that said, all right, Daniel, if you can sign up 10 people to be servants or to be slaves, then you're off the hook. That didn't happen. I'm just trying to share with you the plain text of Scripture. And I'm trying to share with you the path to greatness. And I'm trying to let you understand. I mean, did you read the benefits of this? Let's jump back into Romans chapter 6, right? The fruit you get leads to sanctification, and its end, eternal life. Well, it sounds horrible, doesn't it? No. No, this is the whole plan of redemption. The whole plan of redemption is that, you know, Christ comes to where we are, convicts us of our sin, and we turn that thing over to him. Do you understand what that means? Turning your life over to him, that we make him Lord and Savior? What does that word Lord mean? You know, well, that's just one of the names of God. You know, it's just one of those little handy titles. No, it's not just a handy title. He is Lord. He's Lord of all. And we know that one day every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Now, why do they confess that? Is it something that they're just making up? No, we say that because it is a truth. He is the Lord of all creation. Now, when you think about the great benefits that come with being a servant of the Lord, and I know it still sounds strange, doesn't it? The great benefits of being a servant? Yeah. It works sanctification. It works righteousness. And we have the opportunity to reach into other people's lives and make an investment for time and for eternity. And we have an opportunity to give back to the one who gave us everything. And that's worth investing our lives in. I'm going to read something to you from Exodus chapter 21. The Bible's actually talking here about how you're supposed to manage slaves. And I'm going to go through this passage real quickly. Now, these are the rules that you shall set before them. When you buy a Hebrew slave, he shall serve 6 years, and the seventh, he shall go out free for nothing. If he comes in single, he shall go out single. If he comes in married, then his wife shall go out with him. If his master gives him a wife, and she bears him sons or daughters, the wife and her children shall be her master's, and he shall go out alone. Now, that's kind of a strange passage to be reading. You're saying, let's get to the practical application, because you're kind of losing me in these old laws and regulations that don't have anything to do with us anymore. Well, here we are in verse 5. But if the slave plainly says, I love my master, my wife, and my children, I will not go out free, then his master shall bring him to God, and he shall bring him to the door, the doorpost, and his master shall bore his ear through with an awl, and he shall be his slave forever. And that's the part that I really wanted to get to, because listen, when I came to God, I was broken and had nothing. And since the time that he has redeemed me and put me into his service, he has given me everything. And I want to echo this passage back and say, I love my master and I love what he's done for me. And I don't want to go free, because that freedom isn't really a freedom. I have found that there is freedom in Christ, that there is freedom in service to what God has put in front of me to do. And listen, just give yourself over to that. You're not going to improve on God's plan for your life. So just go along with what he has for you and be content in knowing and understanding the perfect will of God. That's what I meant the other day when I said, let's start living the kingdom right now. Because the kingdom right now, the king has said, the king has spoken, the royal edict has been decreed. The greatest among you will be the servant of you all. Well, I'm Brother Daniel. It's been Manna Minutes. I wish you happy service today. And remember to be good, have fun, and do it in that order. Have you ever held a doubt what this life is all about? Have you questioned all this is?